Beeching cuts the branch lines. Committee of the British Transport Commission was formed in 1949 with a brief to close the least used branch lines. A total of 2,363 stations were to close, including 435 already under threat, both on lines that were to close and on lines that were to remain open. Traffic to Coventry, Birmingham, Manchester, Liverpool, and Scotland would be routed through the West Coast Main Line to Carlisle and Glasgow. Traffic to the northeast would be concentrated through the East Coast Main Line, which was to be closed north of Newcastle, and traffic to Wales and the West Country would go on the Great Western Main Line to Swansea and Plymouth. In Scotland, only the Central Belt routes and the lines via Fife and Perth to Aberdeen were selected for development, and none were selected in Wales, apart from the Great Western Main Line as far as Swansea. Reprieved lines include lines through the Scottish Highlands, such as the Far North Line, were kept open, in part because of pressure from the powerful Highland lobby. As a result, some lines it had not recommended for closure were subsequently shut down, such as the Woodhead Line between Manchester and Sheffield in 1981, after the freight traffic on which it had relied declined. Many redundant structures from closed lines remain, such as bridges over other lines and drainage culverts. Some lines, such as the Sunderland-to-West Hartlepool line, cost only £291 per mile to operate. Traffic on the single-track Golden Valley line between Kemble and Swindon and the Cotswold line between Oxford and Worcester has increased significantly, and double-track has now been reinstated on the Golden Valley line, partly to facilitate a diversionary route during electrification and other works on the Severn tunnel line. Section 39 of the Transport Act 1968 made provision for grants to be paid in relation to loss-making lines and services, but many of the services and railway lines that would have qualified had already been closed. FCD 683E 138BB.